I wonder if there's any worshipers in this place tonight. Can just lift up your hands and just make a commitment to him. God, I'm going to bless you. God, I'm going to bless you. I know I'm going through some stuff right now, and it looks like I may not ever come out, but I'm going to bless you. If you know it, sing it with me. For so long, I'm silent. Come on, say it with me. For so long, I did not have a song of praise. Depression filled my days, and clouds blocked my way, but there was a voice speaking to me.
When I think I was 15, I did my first line of cocaine, and I was just mesmerized by it. I literally was an extremist. I wanted to be high 24/7. I was going to school high, leaving school at lunch to go get high.
Wes Morgan grew up a preacher's kid.
I lived in a healthy environment. I had a true example of a loving mother and father, but I still got off track. I got sideswiped.
Wes spent time in juvenile detention. Then at 17, he was charged with armed robbery. One night he was high on Valium when he threatened a group of people with an axe.
I remember waking up, it was a Sunday morning. I woke up and I was still drunk. My mother's waking me up. She says, Wes, I don't know what you have done, but the cops have called here this morning and we have got to take you to the police station.
Before long, Wes was using drugs again.
I would literally snort drugs. I would snort cocaine until literally my nose would swell up. I couldn't.
Wes was high on cocaine one day when a driver wouldn't let him merge. He started to pursue the other car in the midst of a high-speed chase. Wes wrecked the car.
We hit an embankment, probably running about 85, 90 miles an hour. We hit a concrete wall.
Wes's friends were life-flighted out. Wes walked away from the wreck and straight into jail.
It was the end of my rope. And I remember asking one of the security guards, the correctional officers, to get me a Bible. And I grabbed that Bible, and I didn't depart from that Bible for 8 days solid. I was so tired of always watching my life slip through my fingers. Never able to get a hold of Wes. And so I think that God heard a silent scream coming from me, from my spirit, get me out of this. I've got to get free.
Wes rededicated his life to Christ that night in the jail cell. He was instantly delivered from his addictions.
He didn't.
Wes is the associate minister in his parents' church. Also a musician, he tours performing songs off his recently released debut album.
People who have gone down as far as I go down never come back around. I'm smelling roses every day. I'm taking advantage of not having a nag in my belly to go get high. You know what that feels like for me? It's like that itself is euphoric.